Did you know that in AutoCAD, an object can be on more than one layer at a time? And why would you even want to do that? I've got answers to both of these questions in this video. First of all, usually when something is on more than one layer, it's a part of a block. And as far as the second part, I'll show you why it's important and how you can use this to your advantage. But first thing I want to do is create a block. So I'm going to create some geometry and make a block out of it. I'm going to start off with a rectangle, just for the sake of having something to draw. And let's say we'll start at 2, 2 and go to 5, 5. And I've drawn this rectangle right here on layer 0. Now the important thing about drawing an object on layer 0, if it's going to be a part of a block, is in a block, anything drawn on layer 0 will inherit the properties of the target layer. And we'll see that in a few minutes. But I'm going to change my layer, and I'm going to say, let's go to this hidden layer here, and I'm going to add some more geometry. So I'm going to say, let's add a circle to this block. And then just for fun, let's add a couple more lines here. So I'll say from there, from there to there, and from there to there, just so that it's terribly obvious that I have different layers at work in this block. This one's on layer 0, okay, this rectangle's on layer 0, and then the rest of this geometry is on that layer called M hidden. Now when I come in here to make the block, I'll say let's create the block, and I will call this sample 1 just to give it a name. My insertion point will be the midpoint of that line there, and my objects are those right there, and say okay, and I'm going to delete this. And now that block is a part of the block library. If I go to insert, you'll see that there it is right there as sample 1. Okay. Now if I come in here and I insert this block into the drawing, I'm going to insert it on my M visible layer here. So I come in here and I insert it, sample 1, bam. If I look at it right off the bat, the object that was on layer 0, okay, which was that rectangle, you'll see has now inherited the properties of my target layer, invisible. It has a continuous line type, it's that yellow color. If I turn on my line weights, you'll see that it's got the thicker line weight, and then everything is good to go. But the other thing is that the hidden lines, okay, are still represented the way they were. The hidden lines in that block were cyan, and they were the hidden 2 line type, and they're there as well. It turns out that those hidden lines are on 2 layers at the same time. They're on the invisible layer, because that was the target layer that I inserted my block on, and they're also on that hidden line layer. And this is important because maybe I've got some geometry that I want to show in different ways. There might be an instance where I don't want the hidden lines shown in this block. So I can come in and I can freeze, for example, the hidden line layer, and those hidden lines go away, okay? But if I freeze the visible layer, if I set 0 current, for example, and I come in and I freeze the visible layer, the current layer, everything goes away. So those hidden lines are on 2 layers at one time, and it gives me more flexibility in how I want the geometry in that block to be displayed. So it's a little trick that maybe you weren't aware of, but something that hopefully you can figure out a way to use it in your drawings. Hope you have a good day. Thanks for watching.